So we are on the Ciudad Juarez, Mexico side of the international bridge that connects us with El Paso and the United States of America. We're here to meet families who are fleeing persecution and violence, seeking to follow our own asylum laws to find safety, but this administration has forced to stay in Juarez. We're seeking to understand from these families just what it is like for them and hope that this informs U.S. policy for the better.
Jacob, ¿cuántos años tiene?
Seven.
Cuatro. Qué bueno.
Sí, nosotros hemos estado unidos y al momento que llamaba a mi familia, no ha podido estar aquí. Y se me dijo que yo no podía estar con ellos, que yo no podía ayudar.
¿Y con quién veniste? ¿Con tu familia?
Con mis padres y mis hermanos.
There are her family's now in Los Angeles, California. She's here in a shelter in Ciudad Juarez, Mexico.
¿Y cuánto tiempo tiene usted aquí en este albergue?
Llevamos 3 meses. 3 meses.
Yo le pedí al juez que me ayudara para poder pasar, porque yo necesito no por un sueño, sino por salvar la vida de los niños.
Una persona, una mujer falleció, quedó en el desierto. Murió de sed. Y créanme que uno quisiera ayudar, pero no puede. No puede. Lo único que hace es llorar y pedirle a Dios.
There are thousands of asylum seekers from Central America who are now in Ciudad Juarez. The shelter that we were just at has space for maybe 500. So that means that there are thousands more living on the streets of Juarez, causing people to contemplate crossing in between our ports of entry across the U.S.-Mexico border unlawfully, which means that they are, if they survive the journey, and some do not, they are picked up by Border Patrol agents, held in Border Patrol custody in these freezing rooms that they call hileras, where the lights are on all the time. They're very often sleeping on concrete floors under aluminum blankets. We know where we're going right now in Clint, Texas. There's a Border Patrol station that had hundreds of children, ages 5 months to 17 years. This is a very inhumane, very cruel policy. It is not by accident. It is on purpose.
Thank you for bearing witness to what is happening in our name right now in the United States of America. The only way this is going to get better, the only way that it's going to change, the only way that we can really be here for those kids is to be here right now for those kids and to share with our fellow Americans just what is being done in our name. Story with everyone in your life to make sure that at this moment of truth, we all do what is required of us so that our kids, generations that follow, are proud of us, the people of 2019. Thank you all for being here.